Today concept is, first, there are two ways of testing. One is manual testing, other one is automation testing. What do you mean by manual testing? Tell me, what do you mean by manual testing? Satish and Kumar, tell me, anyone.
Testing in which a person is
What do you mean by manual testing? Already manual testing over.
manual testing is a process. Hello?
Yeah, tell me.
Hello, sir.
What do you mean by manual testing?
Hello.
Yes,
yes sir, the manual testing is a process in which that hello.
Yeah, tell me.
Are you able to listen, Mr.?
I can hear you.
Sir, I am starting, but no, you are speaking in between. Okay, sir. Manual testing is a process in which defects are identified and rectified manually.
Okay.
There is no automation used. I mean, test cases are created manually, and you have to enter the take the values and then check whether it has any defects or not.
Yes.
Manually.
Yes, yes. That is manual testing. Manual testing means everything we will do manually. Everything we will do manually. Everything we will
yeah.
do manually. Everything we will do manually. Everything we will do manually. That's why that is called manual testing. So that is the mass definition. If you want class definition, manual testing is nothing but this is the one of the type of testing in which all the phases of software testing life cycle, like test planning, test development, test execution, result analysis, bug tracking and reporting are accomplished successfully with our efforts, with human efforts, everything we will do. All the phases of software testing life cycle. Software testing life cycle contains 6 phases: test planning, test development, test execution, result analysis, bug tracking and reporting are accomplished successfully with our efforts, with human efforts. So that's why that is called manual testing. Already manual testing existed in the market. Why automation came into market? That means in manual testing we have some drawbacks. What are the main drawbacks in manual testing?
It will take more time to sort out the
yes
test cases.
Yes, I will tell you. First point, more number
Hello?
Of people required. More number of people.
Hello.
Yes, Kumar. More number of people required.
Sir, give me 2 minutes. Sir, 2 minutes. Just give me 2 minutes. Sir.
Okay. Okay. More number of people required.
Okay, sir.
Time consuming. No accuracy. No accuracy means less accuracy.
अरे थोड़ा सा केस का डिस्क्राइब कर दो ना.
Tiredness. We cannot repeat the task again. We can't repeat the task again and again.
క్వాలిటీ సెంటర్ చెప్తా అన్నారు కదా.
యా సో జస్ట్ బేసిక్స్ జస్ట్ ఇంట్రొడక్షన్. వి కాంట్ రిపీట్ ద టాస్క్ అగైన్ అండ్ అగైన్. సైమల్టైనియస్ యాక్షన్స్ నాట్ పాసిబుల్. It is not a consistent process. It is a bore process. There is nothing to learn new things. There is nothing to learn new things. So these are the main drawbacks in manual testing. More number of people required. So if it is manual testing, more number of people required. Time consuming, it will take more time. And no accuracy. No accuracy means less accuracy. We are doing manually, so tiredness. We cannot repeat the task again and again. And simultaneous actions not possible. It is not a consistent process. It is a bore process. There is nothing to learn new things. There is nothing to learn new things. This is manual testing. And next, what do you mean by automation testing? Automation testing. What do you mean by automation testing? Automation also one of the type of testing in which all the drawbacks in manual testing are addressed properly and provide give. It will provide speed and accuracy to the existing process. It will give speed and accuracy to the existing testing process. Speed and accuracy. Automation also one of the type of testing in which all the drawbacks in manual testing are addressed properly and provide speed and accuracy to the existing testing process. So automation also one of the type of testing. All the drawbacks in manual testing are addressed properly and provide speed and accuracy to the existing testing process. So here one note, you need to remember one note. Automation is not a replacement of manual testing. Automation is not a replacement of manual testing. This is the continuation part of manual testing. Automation is not a replacement of manual testing. This is the continuous part of the manual testing. Automation is not a replacement of manual testing. This is the continuation part of the manual testing. If it is any project compulsory, we should do manually only. If it is any project compulsory, we should do manually only. So manually is nothing but it is a basic process. Automation is nothing but it is an advanced process. Automation is nothing but it is an advanced process. If it is any project compulsory, we need to do manually. If it is any project, we need to do manually only, first of all. After getting stability, we can implement automation testing. Whenever you are facing the interview also, that time they may ask you, like, when can you implement automation testing? Whenever the application is stable condition, then only we can implement automation testing. Whenever the application is stable condition, then only we can implement automation testing. Whenever the application is stable condition, then only we can implement automation testing. Whenever the application is stable condition, then only we can implement automation testing. When can you implement automation testing? Whenever the application is stable condition, then only we can implement automation testing. So if it is any project compulsory, we should do manually only. After getting stability, we can implement automation testing. Stable means after entire application, after developing the entire application, then only we can implement automation testing. Manual testing part wise also we can do. Automation testing, whenever the application is stable condition, then only we can implement automation testing, then only we can get good results. But wherever you go, still 80 to 90% of the companies still they are depending upon manual process. Wherever you go, 80 to 90% of the companies still they are depending upon manual process. Why they are depending upon manual process? That means in automation also we have some drawbacks. In automation also we have some drawbacks. In automation also we have some drawbacks. What are the main drawbacks automation testing? First one, professionals required. First drawback, professionals required. If it is manual testing, we can give training within 1 week and we can take into project. Okay, or we can give training within 1 day and we can take into project. But if it is automation, compulsory technical knowledge people required, like something scripting languages required. So technical knowledge people required. That means professionals required. Second point, tools are very expensive. Tools are very expensive. Whenever you are comparing with manual testing, tools are very expensive. Tools are very expensive. Whenever you are comparing to manual testing, tools are very expensive. So if it manually is the cheapest testing process, manually is the cheapest testing process. So automation drawbacks, first point, professionals required. Second point, tools are very expensive. Third point, we can't automate all the areas using tools also. This is the main drawback. That's the reason most of the people, 80 to 90% of people, still they are depending upon manual process. Why they are depending upon manual process? Professionals required, and the tools are very expensive. We can't automate all the areas using tools also. This is the main drawback. That is the reason 80 to 90% of people, not only in India, wherever you go, if it is US or Australia, Ireland, New Zealand, UK, Canada, wherever you go, all the companies still 80 to 90% of the companies still they are depending upon manual process. All right. Yeah, automation tool introduction. Automation tool. Automation tool. Yeah, automation tool is nothing but automation tool is
an automation tool, sir.
An automation tool is nothing but it is an assistant of test engineer. It is an assistant of test engineer. The automation tool is nothing but it is an assistant of test engineer. If you want work with any your assistant, for example, I have an assistant from Orissa. For example, I have an assistant, he is from Orissa. I know Telugu, he don't know Telugu. I know Hindi, he don't know Hindi. I know English, he don't know English. He knows only Oriya. First of all, I should learn Oriya. Then only I can give the instructions and information. Without giving instructions and information, he will not do anything. Simply, he will sit. So, if you want to work with a automation tool, compulsory, you should know five basic things. If you want to work with any automation tool, you should know five basic things. First point, how to give the instructions. Second point, how to give the information. Third point, how to use its recording facility. How to use its playback facility. How to analyzing the results. If you know these things, you can work with any automation tool. If you want to work with any automation tool, first of all, you should know five basic things, how to give the instructions and how to give the information, how to use its recording facility, how to use its playback facility, how to analyzing the results. If you know these things, you can work with any automation tool, not only Selenium, not only QTP. So here my assistant is Selenium. My assistant is Selenium. I know Telugu, Selenium don't know Telugu. I know Hindi, Selenium don't know Hindi. I know English, Selenium don't know English. Selenium knows Java, comma Perl, comma Python, comma C sharp, comma Ruby. So first of all, we should learn any of the scripting language, then only we can work with Selenium. So if you want to work with Selenium, Selenium is my assistant. If I want to work with Selenium, first of all, I should learn any of the scripting language. Java, Perl, Python, C sharp, Ruby. Wherever you go, nearly 99% of the companies, they are using Java with Selenium. So first of all, if you want to work with Selenium, first of all, we should learn Java. Okay, right. Before going to Java, first of all, automation tools in the market. Automation tools in the market. Automation tools. There are different types of tools available in the market. First one, functional tools. Functional tools means compulsory we need to perform some actions on the functionality, then only we can say that functionality is properly working or not. That type of tools is called functional tools. Compulsory we should perform some actions on the functionality, then only we can say that functionality is properly working or not. So the type of tools is functional tools. So first one, WinRunner. WinRunner. So this is the first tool for functional tool. So this is not user friendly. That is the reason none of the people not using WinRunner nowadays. It is deprecated. After that, they made RFT, rational functional tool, IBM tool, rational functional tool. This is also one of the functional tool. This is also not user friendly. That's the reason none of the people not using RFT also. After that, they introduced QTP, Quick Test Professional, 1994 to 2012, nearly 18 years in the market. That is QTP is the most demandable tool previously, not now. So after that, they encouraged, they released Selenium. Most demandable tool in the world, that is Selenium. So first of all, we should know what are the main differences between QTP and Selenium. QTP is a functional tool, or Selenium also functional tool. What are the main differences between QTP and Selenium? QTP also functional tool, Selenium also functional tool. QTP developed by Mercury people in 1994. Selenium introduced by Jason Huggins in 2004. QTP is a commercial tool. If you want QTP license, nearly 3 to 5 lakhs we should pay. Nearly 3 to 5 lakhs we should pay. Selenium is an open source tool. If you have internet connection, you can download and you can use. So using QTP, we can work with normal window-based applications as well as web applications. Selenium only for web applications. Selenium only for web applications. In using QTP, we can work with only IE browser very comfortably. IE. Here we can work with multi browsers. In QTP, we can use only VB scripting language. Here we can use multi scripting language. In QTP, main feature recording and playback facility. Recording and playback facility. In Selenium, main component web driver. Main component web driver we don't have. We don't have RPB. RPB means recording and playback facility. We don't have any RPB, recording and playback facility. These are the main differences between QTP and Selenium. So Selenium is an open source tool. If you have internet connection, we can work with Selenium very comfortably. Selenium is very, very user friendly. That's the reason most of the people, most of the companies nowadays, they are using, they are encouraging only Selenium, Selenium, Selenium. Most demandable tool in the world, that is Selenium. All right. Selenium introduction. Selenium. What is Selenium? What is Selenium? Selenium is nothing but it is a software. Which contains. Some set of programs. Selenium is nothing but it is a software which contains some set of programs. Selenium having. Four components. Selenium having four components. One is Selenium IDE. Selenium having four components. One is Selenium IDE. Selenium RC. Selenium WebDriver. Selenium Grid. Selenium having four components, Selenium IDE, Selenium RC, Selenium WebDriver, and Selenium Grid. First, we will discuss IDE. What is Selenium IDE? IDE means Integrated Development Environment. IDE means Integrated Selenium IDE is nothing but it is the Integrated Development Environment. What is Selenium IDE? Selenium IDE is nothing but it is a software. Same definition, framework definition. Selenium IDE is nothing but it is a software which contains some set of programs. Selenium IDE is nothing but it is a software which contains some set of programs. This set of programs we need to install into one user interface. We need to install into one user interface. Why? Because these are the programs. So we need to install into one user interface. In the place of user interface, we are using IDE only. No need to install somewhere. So what is Selenium IDE? Selenium IDE is nothing but it is a software which contains some set of programs. This set of programs we need to configure into one user interface. Why? Because directly we can't interact with these programs. Compulsory, we need one user interface. We need one user interface. In the place of user interface, we are using IDE only. No need to install somewhere. No need to install somewhere. So whenever you want to work with Selenium IDE, Selenium IDE advantages. We need to configure into one user interface. Selenium IDE is nothing but it is a software which contains some set of programs. This set of programs we need to configure into one user interface. In the place of user interface, we are using IDE only. Selenium IDE advantages. We have recording and playback facility. We have recording playback facility, RPB. We have recording and playback facility. We have recording and playback facility. And execution will be super fast. Disadvantages. We can work with only Firefox browser. We can perform very limited testing. We can perform very limited testing. Firefox browser. We can work with only Firefox browser and we can perform very limited testing. That is the reason none of the people not using Selenium IDE nowadays. It is deprecated. It is deprecated. It is deprecated. It is deprecated. After that, they made Selenium RC. What is Selenium RC? Selenium, same definition. Selenium RC is nothing but it is a software which contains some set of programs. This set of programs we need to configure into one user interface. In the place of user interface, Selenium IDE, Selenium RC means remote control. So Selenium RC is nothing but it is a software which contains some set of programs. This set of programs we need to configure or we need to install into one user interface. In the place of user interface, we are using Eclipse. Eclipse is nothing but it is a powerful editor to write the Java programs. If you want to write the Java programs, always we will use Eclipse. Always we will use Eclipse. So whenever you want to work with Selenium RC, whenever you want to work with Selenium RC, we need to start the server manually. We need to stop the server manually. Whenever you want to work with Selenium RC, we need to start the server manually and we need to stop the server manually. Using Selenium RC also, we can perform very limited testing. That's the reason none of the people not using Selenium IDE and Selenium RC. Both are deprecated. Both are deprecated. Both are deprecated. But still, I will show you. Still, I will show you. So, Selenium RC and Selenium IDE both are deprecated. After that, they made Selenium WebDriver. What is Selenium WebDriver? Same definition. Same definition. Selenium WebDriver is nothing but it is a software which contains some set of programs. This set of programs we need to install into one user interface. In the place of user interface, we are using Eclipse. We are using Eclipse. Sir, both set of same now. What is the main difference between Selenium RC and Selenium WebDriver? Yes, both set of same. So, but whenever you are comparing with the Selenium RC, Selenium WebDriver having some powerful set of programs. Whenever you are comparing with the RC, Selenium WebDriver having some powerful set of programs. Using Selenium WebDriver, we can perform unlimited testing. Using Selenium WebDriver, we can perform unlimited testing. Selenium WebDriver is very, very user friendly. So this file is recording today, first class I am seeing. Without knowing Java also, even fourth class kid also, you can learn Selenium very comfortably. Without knowing anything, we can learn this Selenium WebDriver. Why? Because it is very, very user friendly. And at the same time, using Selenium WebDriver, we can perform unlimited testing. That is the reason most of the people, most of the companies nowadays, they are using, they are encouraging only Selenium WebDriver only. Okay, using Selenium WebDriver, we can perform unlimited testing, and Selenium WebDriver is very, very user friendly. That is the reason most of the people, most of the companies nowadays, they are using, they are encouraging only Selenium WebDriver only. Using Selenium WebDriver, we can perform unlimited testing, and Selenium WebDriver is very, very user friendly. Okay, right. Last component, that is Selenium Grid. What is Selenium Grid? Selenium Grid is nothing but it is a software which contains some set of programs. It is a software which contains some set of programs. Using these programs, we can run the test parallelly on multiple machines. At a time, we can run the test parallelly on multiple machines. What is the main use? We can increase the performance of the execution. We can increase the performance of the execution. We can increase the performance of the execution. That is Selenium Grid. Selenium Grid is nothing but it is a software which contains some set of programs. Using these programs, we can run the test parallelly on multiple machines. If it is single test or multiple tests, we can execute on multiple systems at a time. Or if it is single program or multiple programs at a time, we can execute on multiple systems. So what is the main use? We can increase the performance of the execution. We can increase the performance of the execution, right? That is Selenium introduction. Before going to Selenium, first of all, we should learn Java. First of all, we should learn Java. We should learn Java. So I will give you Java software. So it will install within 2 minutes. If it is any operating system, it will install in within 2 minutes. And I will give you Eclipse. First, Java we need to install in our computer, in our laptop or computer. So it will support all operating systems. Java will install 2 minutes only. While installing Java, internet connection required. While installing Java, internet connection required. Next one is Eclipse. There is no installation for Eclipse. There is no installation for Eclipse. Each and every time we should run. So there is no installation for Eclipse. Each and every time we should run. So after installing Java, and we need to run the Eclipse. Each and every time we should run. Okay, right. First concept in Java, primitive data types. Primitive data types. In Java, we have 8 primitive data types. In Java, we have 8 primitive data types. In Java, we have 8 primitive data types. First one is byte, short,
long,
float,
double,
boolean, char. In Java, we have 8 primitive data types: byte, short, int, long, float, double, boolean, char. So, first byte. First four data types are used for store the integer values. Any numeric values we will store the, we will use for store the integer values or numeric values. If you want to store the integer values means numeric values. Integer values are numeric values. Number of hands, number of legs, number of fingers, number of buses, number of countries, number of states, number of districts, number of fans, number of lights, number of computers, number of books, number of mobile phones, number of chairs, number of lights. So any number, if you want to store any number, that time you will use first four data types. First four data types are used for store the integer value or numeric values. So why we need four, sir? Oh, each and every one having own range. Byte is 8 bit. Short is 16 bit. Int is 32 bit. Long is 64 bit. Float and double are used for store the decimal values. My height is 5.7. So that is the decimal value. So 0.004. So that is decimal value. If you want to store the decimal values, we will use float and double. Float and double. If you want to store the decimal values, we will use float and double. Float is 32 bit. Double is 64 bit. Boolean is used for store the true or false. If you want to store the true or false, we will use boolean. True or false. If you want to store the true or false, we will use boolean. Char is used for store the single character. If you want to store the single character, we will use char. So 8 bit means this range is -2 power of 7 to -2 power of 7 -1. That means -128 to +127. In between values we can store in byte. -128 to +127. 2 power of 7 means 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2. So that means 7 times. So 2 twos are 4, 4 is 16. 16, 16 2, 32, 64, 128. So -128 to +127. In between values we can use, we will store in byte, short, int, long. So first byte, this range is -128 to +127. In between values we will store in byte. So next short is 16 bit. So next 32 bit long, long 64 bit. Okay, right. Here you should remember only one thing, very very important thing. String is not a data type in Java. String is not a data type in Java. It is a predefined function in Java. Yes, this is very very important point. String is not a data type in Java. It is a predefined function in Java. String is not a data type in Java. It is a predefined function in Java. String is not a data type in Java. It is a predefined function in Java. Right. So just now, today. So already I installed Java. So go and check it installed or not. Go to C, program files. Yes, Java folder is there. That means Java installed. Go to computer, C, program files. Check it. Java, if it is Java folder is there, that means Java installed. Java installed. Next to Eclipse, each and every time we should run. This is the Eclipse software I will give you after class. I will give you. This is the Eclipse software. Each and every time we should run. There is no installation for Eclipse. Double click on it. We can get Eclipse ball. This is the Eclipse ball. Each and every time we should run. Double click on it. it will install, it will take 2 minutes. So it is asking where you want these programs, where you want. I'm giving path, I'm giving path, I'm giving path. Go to my computer, I'm giving F drive, new folder, a key, Eclipse. Click on OK. I want to store the program in akki.eclipse in F drive. Click on OK. I am giving path where you want. It is asking. So this program's where you want. It is asking. I gave path in the F drive. So close the welcome window. This is a close welcome window. Close it. Now this is Eclipse. This area is called Project Explorer. This area is called Project Explorer. This area is called Project Explorer. Project Explorer. Project Explorer. This is the save button. This is the save button. Save. This is the run button. This is the run button. So, first of all, if you want to work with Eclipse, first of all, you should know only one thing. So first of all, we should create project. So first we should create project. Next package. Next class. This is the order. I'm creating one package. Right click on Project Explorer. Right click on Project Explorer, go to new, take the project. I'm taking one project name is, I'm taking project Hyderabad. I'm taking one project Hyderabad. After creating project, in this folder we can get two folders. One is SRC, second one is JRE. I'm creating one project that is Hyderabad. After creating Hyderabad, we can get two folders. One is SRC, second one is JRE. SRC means source code, JRE means Java runtime environment. SRC means source code, JRE means Java runtime environment. So right click on SRC, we can take the package. Right click on SRC, we can take the package. Right click on package, we can take the class. This is the order. Right click on package, we can take the class. This is the order. Right click on SRC, we can take the. Right click on SRC, we can take the package. Right click on package, we can take the class. Or otherwise, directly we can right click on SRC, we can take the direct class also. Right click on SRC, we can take the class also. Whenever you are doing like this, it will take under default package. 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 This is the order. Without taking package also directly right click on SRC, we can take the class. Directly we can take the class. There are two ways. So right click on SRC, we can take the package. Right click on package, we can take the class. Or otherwise direct right click on SRC, directly we can take the class. Right. So go to Project Explorer, take the new project, Java project. Right click on Project Explorer, once again observe carefully, right click on Project Explorer, take the new project, select Java project, click on next, and giving project name is Hyderabad. Click on finish. No. After creating project, we can get two folders. One is SRC, second one is JRE. Right click on SRC. Take the new package. Pack one. Click on finish. Right click on pack one. Take the new class. Class one. Keep the mark public static void. Keep the mark public static void menu. This is the main method purpose. We are keeping the mark. Why we are keeping the mark, I will tell you later. This is the first class, so I don't want to confuse you. So that's the reason we are keeping the mark. Why we are keeping the mark, I will explain you later. Keep the mark. Click on finish. If you want to increase the font size, we can increase. So how to increase the font size, I will explain you each and every day. So just observe, just go to Windows, Preferences, General, Appearance, Color and Fonts, go to Java, Edit. Now it is 10, I'm keeping 18. Click on OK, apply. Okay, so I'm taking class name is class 1. So this part is called declaration part. This part is called declaration part. This part is called declaration part. So this is the, whenever you are keeping the mark, that time we can get this line. Otherwise we can't get this line. So that's the reason we are keeping the mark. This is the main method. This is main method or main function. So main method or main function. This is called main method or main function. So under class area is called declaration part. And so public static void menu, it is a main method, main function or main method. Okay, right. If you want to write anything in the main method, we can write SYSO, SYSO printed statement, SYSO control space, SYSO control space. It will print to system.out.println. Good evening. So next, if you want to write anything, SYSO control space, SYSO control space, Happy Christmas. Happy Christmas. SYSO control space, Happy Weekend. SYSO control space, boy. SYSO control space, good night. Save, click on run. Control space, SYSO control space. Oh, this is the console. Good evening, Happy Christmas, Happy Weekend, boy, good night. Automatic, whenever you are clicking and run, automatically we can get console. If you want comment single line, we will use double backslash. If you want comment single line, we will use double slash. If you want comment single line, we will use double slash. If you want comment single line, it will syntax is double slash. So now there is no good evening. So I'm commenting that line. Next I want to comment the another line. So at a time I want to comment two lines. That time one slash, one star, and how many lines you want. I want only two lines. I want to comment star slash. That is multi line comments. Single line comment double slash. Multi line comment one slash one star and end of the comment line just star slash. This is multi line comment. This is a multi line comment. Okay, right. And deleting. One second, I will show you how to create project, how to create package, how to create class. Right click on project explorer, take the new project, Java project, click on next. I'm giving project name is Metro. Click on finish. No. After creating project, we can get SRC JRE. Right click on SRC, take the new class. Directly I'm taking class, I'm not taking any package. So I'm giving class name is boy class. Keep the mark public static void menu. Click on finish. So whenever you are keeping the mark, then only we can get this line. So it will take under default package. So whenever you are keeping the mark, then only it will come. This is the main method. So without keeping mark also, we can write it manually. So that is the reason. If you keep the mark, then only this line will come. Otherwise, it will not come. So this is the main method area or main function. So now here, I have not taken any package. So that is the reason it will take under default package. This is very, very important. Okay, right. If you want to write anything, you can write SYSO control space. Hi. SYSO control space. Good night. SYSO control space. Tata. Like we can write it, save, click on run. After writing the code, compulsory we should save the program. Click on run. Okay, we can get hi, good night, tata. All right, based on this knowledge, we will discuss small concept, 1 minute concept, that is access modifiers. Next concept in Java, access modifiers. In Java, we have four access modifiers. One is public, private, public, default, private, protected. In Java, we have four access modifiers: public, default, private, protected. Public, default, private, protected. So already we discussed one order. We discussed now just one order. Like first, if you want to work with Java, compulsor we should create first. We should create project. Next package. Next class. Okay. In Java, we have four access modifiers. One is public, default, private, protected. Whenever you are declaring any function, if you write public, that function we can access in entire project. If you write any function, if you write public, you can access in entire project. If you write it public, you can access entire project. If it is under default package, that function we can access in the package only. If it is any function under default package, we can access in the particular package only. If you write private, we can access that function in the class only. If you write protected, we can access from access in package. If it is protected, if you write protected, we can access in the same package. we can access from same package as well as other pack child class. We can access from other pack child class. We can access in the package as well as the other pack child class. We can access, if you write protected, we can access in the package as well as we can call, we can access from other pack child class. So these are the access modifiers. These are the access modifiers. These are the access modifiers. Okay, shall we write the program today? Are you okay? Do you have time, Kumar?
Yes, sir.
You have time?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, yes.
Okay, only 10 to 15 minutes or half an hour, minimum 20 minutes. So today first concept we will discuss, very very important concept. If you understand today concept, you can play with Java, otherwise Java can play with you. Okay, very very important concept. So first concept in Java, that is we will discuss today. Yes, first concept, static methods. Static methods, non-static methods, static methods, non-static methods, static methods, non-static methods. So for example, so static means common, static means common, static properties, non-static properties, static means in Java, for example, common, static means common, static means common, non-static means not common, non-static means not common. So for example, wherever you go, there are two categories of people, one is boys, other one is girls. Wherever you go, there are two categories of people, one is boys, other one is girls. Category is nothing but it is a class. Category is nothing but it is a class. For example, I am taking one boy class. I am taking one boy class. All the boys having some common properties, that properties is called static properties. All the boys having some common properties, that properties is called static properties. What are the properties all the boys commonly having? Number of hands, number of legs, number of hands, number of legs. Non-static properties. All the boys not having commonly, that properties is called non-static properties. What are the properties all the boys not having commonly? What are the properties all the boys not having commonly? Non-static means not common. What are the properties all the boys not having commonly? Name and color. Height also, weight also. Next, static actions. All the boys commonly do some actions. That actions is called static actions. All the boys commonly do some actions. That actions is called static actions. All the boys not do commonly, that reactions is called non-static actions. All the boys not do commonly, that reactions is called non-static actions. What are the actions all the boys not do commonly? What are the actions all the boys not do commonly? What are the actions all the boys commonly do? Breathe and sleep. So this is the function or reaction. So if it is function or reaction, like we can write sleep, drink and sorry, breathe and sleep is a static actions. All the boys commonly do non-static actions. All the boys not do commonly, that actions is called non-static actions. Drink and smoke. All the boys not do commonly, that actions is called non-static actions. All the boys not do commonly, that actions is called non-static actions. Static actions, breathe and sleep. Non-static action, drink and smoke. Right. So here you should remember only three things. If you want to learn Java, you should know three things. First point, if you want store non-static stuff, if you want to store non-static stuff, compulsory memory location required. I'm talking about only non-static. If you want to store the non-static stuff, compulsory memory location required. First point, if you want to learn Java, you should know three things. First point, if you want to store the non-static stuff, compulsory memory location required. I'm giving memory location name is new. So non-static stuff, what are those? Name and color. Name, color, drink, smoke. I'm talking about only non-static. If you want to store the non-static stuff, compulsory memory location required. Second point. If you want to add anything to memory location, comma, if you want to get anything from memory location, reference name required. If you want to add anything to object memory location, or if you want to get anything from object memory location, this is the memory location. If you want to add anything to object memory location, if you want to get anything from object memory location, compulsory reference name required. If you want to add anything to object memory location, if you want to get anything from object memory location, compulsory reference name required. Third point, object creation. If it is non-static, we need to create the object. Third one, object creation. Class name, reference name, equal to new class name. I'm talking about only non-static. Class name, reference name, equal to new class name. For example, class name boy. Reference name, your choice, B1, equal to new boy. Class name, reference name, equal to new class name. Class name, boy, reference name, B1, equal to new boy. Okay. For example, class name is Akhil. Akhil, A1, equal to new Akhil. Class name, reference name, equal to new class name. This is the only one line, only for non-static. I'm talking about only non-static. If you want to learn Java, you should know three things. If you want to store the non-static stuff, compulsory memory location required. If you want to add anything to object memory location, if you want to get anything from object memory location, reference name required. So if it is non-static, we need to create the object. So object creation syntax, class name, reference name equal to new class name. Class name is, for example, I am taking boy, B1 equal to new boy. So by B1 equal new by B1 is reference name, new is memory location. New is memory location, B1 is reference name. First point, second point. All right. So directly we can write the book. B1 is reference name, new is memory location. B1 is reference name, new is memory location. Right. Now go to Eclipse. Directly we can write the program, simple program. And deleting everything once again. Go to Project Explorer, take the new project, Java project, click on next. Project name is I'm giving India. Click on finish. No. After creating project, we can get two folders, SRC, JRE. Right click on SRC, take the new class. I'm taking class name is boy, B-O-Y, boy. Keep the mark public static void menu. Click on finish. So this is the declaration part. Properties, we learned properties only for general knowledge purpose. So first, static properties. How to declare static properties? First point, how to declare static properties? We have number of hands, number of legs. So public, if it is static, we need to mention static, public, static. So number of hands, data type, which data type we can use? Int, number of hands. Number of legs, public, static, int, number of legs. No space, we can use underscore also, but no space. Okay, this is the just for general knowledge purpose. GK, static properties. Right. Next, non-static properties. Name and color, public. Name, data type, string name. So if it is static, we need to mention static. If it is non-static, no need to mention anything. Public, height, color also string. Yes. COLOUR, color. Next, if it is static, we need to mention static. If it is non-static, no need to mention anything. Non-static properties. Right. Actions or functions. Public, static. If it is static, we can write static. Void, breathe. This is the function. Breathe is a function. Start the curling bracket. SYSO control space. Breathe. This is the function body. Next, sleep. Next, drink. Next, smoke. If it is function, we will write void. Why we are writing void, I will explain you later. This is the first class only. So why we are writing void, I will explain you later. Sleep. If it is function, we will write void. Why we are write why we need to write void, I will explain you. So to static function, breathe and sleep is a static functions. And drink and smoke is a non-static functions. Drink and smoke is a non-static functions. Function or reaction, we can say anyone. So here I wrote two static functions, two non-static functions. So here only one line. Just remember, breathe directly I can call from main method. This is the main method, directly we can call breathe. Sleep also directly we can call. Why? Because both are static. If I write drink directly, it will show error. Why? Because it is a non-static. So if it is non-static, what we need to do? We need to create object. How to create object? Class name is boy. Reference name as your choice, B1 equal to new boy. Boy B1 equal to new boy. B1 dot drink, B1 dot smoke. B1 dot smoke. So that is the concept, static method, non-static method. Total concept says only one thing. If it is static, directly we can write in the main method. We can call from main method. If it is non-static, we need to create the object. How to create the object? Class name, reference name equal new class name. Sir, I'm confusing, sir. Breathe, sleep, which one is static, which one is non-static? I'm confusing. Okay, right. Just once execute it. Save, click on run. So breathe, sleep, drink, smoke. So whatever we wrote, that logic, it will print in console. Go breathe, sleep, drink, smoke. So for example, using ABCD also we can write the program. A, static function I am writing. బి ఆల్సో స్టాటిక్, ఏ బి బోత్ ఆర్ స్టాటిక్, సిడి నాన్ స్టాటిక్. ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ సిడి నాన్ స్టాటిక్, సో సిడి నాన్ స్టాటిక్. ఏ డైరెక్ట్ ఐ కెన్ కాల్, వై బికాస్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఎ స్టాటిక్. బి ఆల్సో స్టాటిక్, డైరెక్ట్లీ వీ కెన్ కాల్. సి నాన్ స్టాటిక్, వీ నీడ్ టు క్రియేట్ ద ఆబ్జెక్ట్. అండ్ డి ఆల్సో వీ నీడ్ టు క్రియేట్ ద ఆబ్జెక్ట్. వై బికాస్ దీస్ ఆర్ ద నాన్ స్టాటిక్. సో టోటల్ దిస్ కాన్సెప్ట్ సేస్ ఇఫ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ స్టాటిక్ డైరెక్ట్లీ వీ కెన్ రైట్ ఇన్ ద మెయిన్ మెథడ్ ఆర్ వీ కెన్ కాల్ ఫ్రమ్ మెయిన్ మెథడ్. ఇఫ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ స్టాటిక్ డైరెక్ట్లీ వీ కెన్ కాల్ ఫ్రమ్ మెయిన్ మెథడ్. ఇఫ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ నాన్ స్టాటిక్ వీ నీడ్ టు క్రియేట్ ద ఆబ్జెక్ట్ విత్ ద రెఫరెన్స్. విత్ ద రెఫరెన్స్ ఓన్లీ వీ కెన్ కాల్, విత్ ద రెఫరెన్స్ ఆబ్జెక్ట్ రెఫరెన్స్ ఓన్లీ వీ కెన్ కాల్ ద ఫంక్షన్. ఏ బి డైరెక్ట్లీ వీ కెన్ రైట్ ఇట్, ఏ ఈ స్టాటిక్, బి ఆల్సో స్టాటిక్, సిడి బోత్ ఆర్ నాన్ స్టాటిక్. సో ఇఫ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ నాన్ స్టాటిక్ వీ నీడ్ టు క్రియేట్ ద ఆబ్జెక్ట్. సో వితౌట్ దిస్ కాన్సెప్ట్ అట్ ఆల్ సింప్లీ ఐ కెన్ సేవ్ ఓన్లీ వన్ లైన్. ఇఫ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ స్టాటిక్ వీ కెన్ కాల్ ఫ్రమ్ మెయిన్ మెథడ్ డైరెక్ట్లీ, వీ కెన్ కాల్ ఫ్రమ్ మెయిన్ మెథడ్. ఇఫ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ నాన్ స్టాటిక్ వీ నీడ్ టు క్రియేట్ ద ఆబ్జెక్ట్. సో ఫస్ట్ దీస్ ఆర్ ద ఫంక్షన్ ప్రాపర్టీస్, నో నీడ్, జస్ట్ ఫర్ జనరల్ నాలెడ్జ్ పర్పస్ వీ డిస్కస్డ్. ఓకే, హోంవర్క్. క్లాస్ నేమ్ ఈజ్ కార్, స్టాటిక్ ప్రాపర్టీస్, స్టాటిక్ యాక్షన్స్, సారీ స్టాటిక్ యాక్షన్స్. రన్ స్లో, రన్ ఫాస్ట్. నాన్ స్టాటిక్ యాక్షన్, నాన్ స్టాటిక్ యాక్షన్స్. ఏసీ, ఎయిర్ బ్యాగ్స్. సో క్లాస్ నేమ్ ఈజ్ కార్, స్టాటిక్ యాక్షన్ రన్ స్లో, రన్ ఫాస్ట్. యా కార్ స్టాటిక్ యాక్షన్స్, రన్ స్లో, రన్ ఫాస్ట్. నాన్ స్టాటిక్ యాక్షన్ ఏసీ, ఎయిర్ బ్యాగ్స్. దిస్ ఈజ్ యువర్ హోంవర్క్. టుమారో హాలిడే, డే ఆఫ్టర్ టుమారో వీ హ్యావ్ క్లాస్. సో డూ దిస్ హోంవర్క్ అండ్ దిస్ సాఫ్ట్వేర్ ఐ విల్ సెండ్ యూ త్రూ స్కైప్ నౌ. సో ఇన్స్టాల్ ఇట్ అండ్ వన్స్ ప్రాక్టీస్ ఇట్ అండ్ డే ఆఫ్టర్ టుమారో వీ హ్యావ్ క్లాస్ ఇండియా టైమ్ 4:30, ఇండియా టైమ్ 4:30 PM. సో దట్స్ యువర్ రెగ్యులర్ టైమ్. ఓకే, హ్యావ్ ఎ నైస్ డే, టేక్ కేర్, ఎంజాయ్, హ్యాపీ వీకెండ్, హ్యాపీ క్రిస్మస్, హ్యావ్ ఎ నైస్ డే, టేక్ కేర్, బాయ్, గుడ్ నైట్.